This is a Be Kind to Pets educational video sponsored by Topayo Vets.
This is a Fox Terrier female, 7 years old. She comes in with the complaint of lameness on the right fore. Sometimes she can put the leg down and sometimes she can't. So what is the problem? Now, as you can see, she doesn't bear weight all the time on the right fore. I will do the examination. Now, normally the examination starts with flexion and extension, abduction and adduction, plus palpation. So I do the palpation first, after visual inspection. Now the dog has been treated yesterday, cleaned up and clipped. So these are the digits of the paw. This is D1, D2, D3, D4, D5. So D1 has been cut off, so this is D2. D2, I want to flex and extend, there's no pain. Abduct and adduct. Adduct can't do, but abduct can, no pain. Now this is the one which appears swollen. Now I will do, so the dog wants to bite me. So there's definitely pain here on extension and on flexion. Not much pain, but still there is. So I will do palpation. Palpation, there is pain, and so the source of lameness will be this D3. RF is right 4, D3 digit. Now this is D4. I will do the D4 now by extending and flexing. Not much response of pain, even on palpation. Okay, then D5 also no problem. So now I do the further up a bit. The metacarpal joint is okay. Then I do the carpal joint. He didn't like it much, so there is a bit of pain there. Then I do the elbow joint, flexion and extension, abduction and adduction, but no pain. The shoulder joint is here. Now, shoulder joint is like in the horse, extend and flex, abduct, but there's no pain. So basically, you compare the two. Now you look at the two front paws, you can see this D3 is exceptionally swollen on the, I would call it the media aspect, as compared to this D3. D1 is a dew claw cut, D2, D3. If you look at the two together, this D3 is definitely 3 times bigger than the D3 here. So you can see, so it's most likely there is some infection or abscess or traumatic injury at this site, and it affects, it's very painful. Now, I've taken an x-ray. The x-ray shows that there's no fracture. But if you can see from here, this part is definitely the swollen part. So it could be an infection or a torn ligament. So now the thing is, we look at the ventral part, see whether there are any wounds or not. Any wounds going in. Bearing in mind that we are concentrating on D3. D2, D3, so we look at D3 here behind, below. And so you can see that definitely there is a big swelling there and the dog doesn't like it. So his swelling is here, deep here. So he might have a penetrating injury 12 days ago or 14 days ago, and infection might have gone in. So I'm giving antibiotics and painkillers. Okay, so x-rays already confirmed there's no fracture. So the diagnosis most likely an infection or traumatic injury, and this will take some time to heal. Okay, let's finish one.